I'm Cynthia Gonzalez.
And I'm Vicki Ngo-Lam. We're product marketing managers at Exabeam.
And today, we're going to get you up to speed on an important practice in cybersecurity called threat hunting.
In this video, we'll explain what it is, but also highlight a few ways to go about it and where to get started. Make sure you watch the end, as we'll cover some common mistakes we've noticed people make when starting out with threat hunting. Threat hunting is the practice of looking for cyber threats that are already in your network. Unlike pen testing, where you're looking for vulnerabilities from the outside, threat hunting assumes the bad guys are already in and need to be found. Why threat hunt? I think everyone in cybersecurity knows that they have threats inside their organization. Threat hunting is a proactive approach to help solve this known problem. Threat hunting is also used to help validate security controls and identify misconfigurations throughout the environment. Threat hunting can be done by anyone on the security team. Some larger organizations have dedicated threat hunters. In others, the more experienced Tier 3 analysts handle the hunting, while the Tier 1 analysts are working on alerts. In smaller organizations, analysts may threat hunt when they find time.
Some organizations outsource threat hunting. It's really a decision that your SOC leadership needs to make. Hiring external expertise or retraining staff who are more familiar with the business and the network. The most common tool used by a threat hunter is a SIEM, which holds the most data from across all of the systems used in an organization. Some may choose to use a security monitoring system, like a firewall or an EDR tool. There are also a handful of specialized threat hunting tools available on the market.
Cynthia, where should I start with threat hunting?
The place to start threat hunting is with a hypothesis, where you think there might be a compromise. Maybe it's a new APT, or you might be concerned that your service accounts are being abused. Maybe you are worried your admin's credentials have been stolen. Once you have your hypothesis, there are essentially three methods for threat hunting.
I think the first way to go is to look for so-called indicators of compromise, or IOCs. These are things like AV signatures, malware hashes, blacklisted IP addresses, and the like. And this approach may sound right, but there are a lot of issues. Like, there are hundreds of millions of IOCs. You may find one, but will probably be lacking context. And that's just one point in a chain of events. Where do you go next? A more modern approach to threat hunting uses the MITRE ATT&CK framework. The acronym stands for Adversarial Tactics, Techniques, and Common Knowledge. The attack matrix shows the various techniques used at each tactical phase of an attack. Really, a step-by-step guide to what the attacker is doing. Going back to your hypothesis, you might focus on the various tactics and techniques an attacker might use to steal a credential. Still, that's a lot of permutations if you look at all of the paths through the attack matrix. Where do you start? How many paths do you follow? The MITRE framework is great, but it needs something more, which brings us to behavioral threat hunting. This uses machine learning to focus on unusual behaviors and connects them with the MITRE framework. For example, you could start your threat hunt for stolen credentials by asking the SIEM to show you the first time a set of credentials was used to access a certain system or VPN from a country for the first time.
You can look at unusual or anomalous behaviors and start with them. This is different from the IOC approach because you're looking at normal employee behavior compared to unusual behavior and asking, what happened? One last tactic is what's called the crown jewels approach. Every organization has them: product designs, customer lists, health records. You might decide to look for unusual access patterns on these crown jewels. Again, behavioral threat hunting will likely be the easiest approach here. A good threat hunter thinks like a bad guy and is familiar with the tactics, techniques, and procedures they use. Getting good just takes practice.
As promised, here's some common mistakes we've seen people make with threat hunting. First, I'd say using IOCs is a mistake. MITRE ATT&CK is a much better system. Combined with behavior, it's a killer combination. Second, make sure your hypothesis is specific. Don't try to boil the ocean or you'll never finish. Last, don't just start slicing the data looking for outliers. You need a clear direction. If you want to be a good threat hunter, learn as much as you can about MITRE ATT&CK. Since behavior is so important, if you aren't already, familiarize yourself with what's called User and Entity Behavior Analytics, or UEBA.
You should also find a source to keep current on new malware and APTs so you have a working knowledge of what you are up against. Also, track breaches. Chances are bad guys will try to reuse what worked, and you should be aware of what that is. There are a number of good videos to help you go deeper into threat hunting and learn how to do it. We've put links in the comments below for a few videos on behavioral threat hunting and hunting with MITRE ATT&CK. If you're thinking about setting up an insider threat program, check out our ebook. It provides a step-by-step guide. Feel free to ask any questions you have in the comments below. We'll be sure to get back to you. If you liked what you saw, give this video some love and subscribe to our channel below. Click on the notification bell so you won't miss any of our new cybersecurity training videos.